Hey everybody, Xander's Mead here. So this is the introduction to 9 questions, my roaring 20s. In order to keep myself focused and not go ragtag all over the place while working on this series, I decided to get things in order before I actually started. This series is going to revisit 9 questions that I was asked in my senior year Bible class. Rummaging through my old writings, I found these questions and the answers that my 17-year-old self wrote. Now while I no longer hold to the answers given, the journey from the pain of my youth and the indoctrination I had so heavily placed on me throughout my life to the eventual period where I took a sledgehammer to those beliefs that I held as true and accurate will help keep me on task and focused as I move through my story. The 9 questions are as follows. What do I believe about God? What do I believe about the Bible? What is the purpose of human existence and my existence? How can I recognize what is good and what is evil? What do I believe about man's relationship to the rest of the cosmos, and how do we fit in? What is the meaning of and the direction of history? What is included in reality? What happens after death, and what do I expect will happen to me after I die? Why do you believe your views to be a true and accurate understanding of life and reality? Those 9 questions, asked at the beginning of what I thought was going to be just one more year of religious indoctrination, started me on a path that would lead me to where I am today in regards to faith in God. In that class, we finally had a chance to learn more about who we really are, and I still refer to that class as my first lesson in psychology. The teacher was a humorous and thought-provoking man that encouraged us to think for ourselves and question absolutely everything. Looking back, I sometimes wonder if he wasn't just another version of who I am now, but able to work within the system in an attempt to break it apart piece by piece and thought by thought. Maybe I'm completely wrong about my assessment of him, but the lessons, the questions, and the continual challenging of all of the beliefs we held true started my mind wondering, pondering, questioning, and doubting, even more than I already did. Part 1 will focus on the first question, and part 2 will focus on the second question, etc. And while I tackle what I believed, I'll keep telling my story about where I was and what I did to keep things interesting and to keep things in perspective. As I've mentioned in a few comments, my deconversion wasn't really a long process, so to speak. Although you could argue that my entire life from age 17 on was my deconversion, I have to emphasize that I still held to my faith and my belief in God and the truth of the Bible, no matter what I did or what questions were raised along the way. I may have never been a good Christian after the age of 16 or so, but that doesn't mean that I wasn't a Christian. The no true Scotsman argument doesn't apply here, just as the prodigal son was still a son while he chased his dreams. I hope everyone enjoys this series, and if you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment, send me a PM, or find me on one of the many social sites I have linked below. As always, thanks for watching, I'm Xander's Meteor, and have a good one.